So you downloaded LumaFusion for your iPad, but you absolutely have zero idea on how you can get started. Well, then don't worry about it. I'm here to help. I will be going step by step, so you don't have to worry even if you're new into video editing. In case you're new over here, hey guys, my name is Prithviraj. I'm an electronic music producer, a part-time gamer, and also I try to make videos. LumaFusion is mostly used because of its ability to export high-quality videos. You can export your project in various resolutions and frame rates, including 4K at the highest bitrate possible. I will recommend using LumaFusion with your Apple Pencil, but it's even better if you get a dedicated mouse and keyboard. It will ease up your workflow even more. I will leave the link of the ones I'm using in the description. So grab your iPad and let's get started. The UI is very clean and easy to understand. So accept all the permissions. You are greeted with three major windows. This one is the media window. You can import and arrange your clips over here. The one on the right is the preview window, and the bottom one is the timeline. Click on the plus button below to create a new project. You can change the aspect ratio manually if you want, else you can just directly sync it with your imported video. I'm gonna rename it and then click on create. Let's import your videos at first. If it's on your iPad already, then just go to all photos and videos and select the media you're looking for. Just simply drag and drop the videos into the timeline. I have these videos of me DJing, so I'll be using that. You can also import via Google Drive or Dropbox by clicking on this button. If you wanted to add your logo or simply wanted to add a few photos, then you can do that as well using this process. You can tap on them to trim or resize the footage. If you want to make a cut in between, then simply click on the scissors icon below and it will do the job for you. And you can also hit that trash button to delete a part of the footage. If you want to zoom the footage, then simply double tap on your desired video. This window will open up after that. From here, you can just simply adjust your size and the positioning of your videos. You can also increase or decrease the speed of your video if you want by adjusting this slider under the speed and reverse tab. If you're enjoying this video so far, then I'd really appreciate if you could hit that subscribe button. It will basically help me feed my cat. Alright, so let's import a song. Click on the three dots and hit on imported media. From there, select your source and click on open and drag and drop your audio into your timeline. You can now trim the song as per your liking. By using the same process, you can import sound effects and other files as well. So what if you had a voiceover in your video and you wanted the volume of the music to be low? Since we don't have any voiceovers in this video, let's record one real quick. You can record your voice straight through LumaFusion, or you can record it somewhere else and then import it. To record straight inside LumaFusion, click on this plus button and select voiceover. Press the record button and it will start recording. Press it again to stop. You can again trim it and chop it just like you would do to any other video file. On the left hand side, you will get to see this volume slider. If it's not visible, then simply click on this button right over here. Now you can use the sliders to adjust the volume of your respective audio layers. To add a text to your video, click on the plus button and it will create a text layer for you. Double tap on that. Now you can add your text over here. You can change the font, color, size, etc. as per your liking. Once you're done, click on back. And now you can drag and place the text layer wherever you want. The undo and redo buttons are placed right below the preview window in case you missed that out. Alright, so those were the basics. But this is a bit advanced, but I'm gonna tell you anyway. Color correction. If you want to add color effects or simply pre-made LUTs or the existing presets, double click on the video and go to the color and effects tab. As you're a beginner, you can simply select an existing color effect and then you can adjust it a bit if you feel there is a need of that. You can simply play around with different looks and LUTs and see what works out for you. Once you're done with your edit, click on the share button below and export it as a movie. You can upload directly to YouTube or you can simply save it to your gallery first. Select your desired resolution and change the video quality to ultra to get the best possible quality. Please smash the like button for me if you found this tutorial helpful. If you want to try out some more video editor, then check out my previous video on the best video editing apps for iPad. You will find a few more professional video editors over there. Thanks for watching and please consider subscribing to my channel for more such videos just like this, and have a great day ahead.